students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our science session. So in our science session we are discussing or we are learning about separation of substances. So in the last video we have discussed about the sedimentation and decantation. Also we have discussed about the filtration method. So today we will move on the next point from the same lesson, that is today we will discuss about separation of soluble solids from a mixture. Okay, so today what we are going to discuss, which separation methods we are going to discuss, that is separation of soluble solids from a mixture. So up till now we have discussed about the insoluble solids from the mixture, how to separate out, and now today we are going to start about the separation of the soluble solids from a mixture. Okay, so for that we are using the one method, that is nothing but what? Evaporation. Okay, so if you have taken the water and the salt, that we can say as the salt solution, so from that salt solution we can separate out the water and the salt. Okay, so generally this method is depends upon, or this evaporation method is depends upon, that we if we give the heat to the solution, then from that, because of that heat, the water or the whatever the water component present in that mixture can get evaporated, and the solid material which get dissolved or which get soluble in that water can remains as it is. Okay, so that is only called as what? Evaporation. So what is meant by the evaporation? The process of changing of a liquid into its vapor. Okay, the process of changing of a liquid into its vapor by heating is called evaporation. It is called as what? Evaporation. So this evaporation method is used to separate out the soluble solids from a mixture. So for that we are having one activity. So let's see that activity.
When we have a mixture of salt in water to separate, we take the solution in a kettle and cover it with a lid. Now gently heat the kettle for some time. Heating transforms water into vapor that escapes from the spout of kettle. Continue heating till all the water gets converted into vapor and only salt is left behind in the kettle. Thus salt dissolved in water can be separated from the water through this process. This process of conversion of water into vapor by heating is called evaporation.
Okay, so now you have seen that how exactly the evaporation process takes place, and with the help of that evaporation process, how to separate out the solid or the soluble solids from a mixture. Okay, so this evaporation method is also used in a nature for to prepare the salt. So as we know, the seawater contains the more amount of the salt. So that sea water is allowed to settle or to collect into the one pond, okay, that is we are calling as a lagoon. And in that pond, because of the heat of the sun, what happened? Whatever the water is there, it get evaporate because of the heat of the sun, and at the shallow ponds we can get the layer of the salt, and that salt is get further purified, and then we can use that salt as a common salt that we are using in our food. Okay, so in this way this evaporation method is used in a preparation of the salt. Now we will move for the next point, that is we will discuss about separation of liquid from a mixture. Okay, separation of a liquid from a mixture means how to separate the liquids from a mixture. So for that process we have to perform the condensation process. Now what is meant by the condensation process? The process of changing vapor into its liquid state. Okay, the process of changing vapor into its liquid state on cooling is called condensation. Okay, so as we know what we are doing in the condensation, whatever the evaporation takes place, we are allowing that all the water vapors to collect, and we are making that water vapor to get cooled down. So that water vapors will get converted into the water by cooling, and that method is only called as what? Condensation. So the process of changing out water vapor into the liquid state on cooling, it is called as what? Condensation. So with the help of this condensation method, we can remove the liquid from a mixture. Okay, we can remove the liquid from a mixture. For that also we are having one activity, so we'll see that activity first.
In order to obtain the water while heating the salt water, hold a plate containing ice just above the spout of the kettle. When the steam escaping through the spout comes in contact with the plate containing ice, it condenses and forms water. This process gives us back the water. This process of conversion of water vapor into water is called condensation.
Okay, so now we have discussed about the condensation. So there are the certain substances which are immiscible. Immiscible means what? These are certain substances which doesn't get mixed in the water. For example, we can say the oil and the water cannot get mixed, which is what? Immiscible. Oil and petrol and the water also doesn't get mixed in the water. So these immiscible liquids we can separate out these immiscible liquids from each other with the help of using the separating funnel. So see here how is the exactly separating funnel. By using this separating funnel we can separate out or we can make a separation process for the immiscible liquids. Okay. Now the next one method we will discuss, that is separation of mixtures by using more than one method. So just now we have discussed about a different method to separate out the substances. But in some case or in some situation, we have to use more than one method to separate out the substances from a mixture. Okay. So for that we are having one activity, that how to separate the sand and the salt from a mixture. So let's see how we will separate out the sand and the salt from a mixture. Before going to see that, what we have to take in the mind, as we know, sand is what? Heavier and insoluble in the water. So first, which method we have to perform? Yes, sedimentation and the decantation. After that we get the solution, that what? It contains the salt. Why? Because the salt is get dissolved in the water. And then we have to perform the evaporation method. Okay. So in this way, what we can say, to separate out certain mixtures, we have to perform more than one method. So let's see this activity.
In a beaker which contains about 100 ml of water, we place equal amounts of salt and sand. Then we use a glass funnel with stem and filter paper. Then we pour the supernatant liquid through the filter. Thank you. we place the beaker on a hot plate for a few minutes until the water vapors.
So here all about today we have discussed the many word methods for the separation of the substances. So here we will stop. It is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.